Welcome back to MCTV. I'm Alex, and I'm going to be your host for the news this morning. The blood drive is Wednesday, so if you're 16 and want to donate blood, go talk to Mr. Strobel in room 229 upstairs. The Ghost Recon run is today, so if you bought a shirt, enjoy the run and watch out for the zombies. If you're a senior, your dues are to be turned in on Monday, and you'll be taking the class picture on Tuesday. Now on something a little more exciting, we're going to take a look at the behind the scenes of the making of MCTV.
All right, you guys, we got a big show ahead of us. Any new ideas? I'm open. Let's hear them.
What if we parody all the other groups?
You know what? That's a great idea. Get that on the board now. Anything else? Anything else?
What if we get viewers to vote on what we do next?
Wait. We don't even have enough viewers for that.
You know what? Don't write that. It's already been done too. Anything else?
I'm fine as long as Red Zone's playing. Wait, what is he doing here for one? Is no one questioning this? He's not in any other group.
The ACT word of the day is vapid. It means tasteless or dull. Synonyms are lifeless or flavorless. For example, the school's lunch food is pretty vapid. I mean, no offense to the lunch ladies or anything, but y'all could use some salt or pepper.
This week I've been listening to I Get the Bag by Migos and Gucci Mane. Be real with me, keep
it 100, just be real with me. So this week I've been nodding, bopping, and singing along the left cheek and right cheeks, popping bottles. They're also known as the cheeks. I stay so fresh, ain't nothing but the best.
I'm in my own lane, should I run this game? So this week I've been listening to Miss It by Young Blue. It's been putting me in my feelings.
Hi, I'm Andy, and this is Today in History. In 1953, the first live color telecast was aired in the U.S. In 1992, Bill Clinton won the U.S. presidential election over George H.W. Bush. Also in 1992, Carol Massey Brown was elected the first African-American woman in the U.S. Senate.
Welcome back to Excuse Me. As you should know by now, I'm your host, Jalen. And if it's not our business, soon it will be. And if it's not about me, we sip tea. Let's go ahead and get this show on the road. As Tuesday, Billboard had reported Taylor Swift tied with Rihanna for most digital song sales at number one. Now that's not my cup of tea, but B said it best. Moving on. Selena and Justin Bieber have been spotted seeing each other again. I guess her and The Weeknd weren't able to work it out. See what I did there? I know you caught it. Anyway, this Halloween, Chris Brown released a 45-track album. Why? Because he can. But let's move into our last topic, as I'm sure you've heard by now. Last Friday, the Migos released their lead single off of their project Culture 2, and it featured none other than the hottest in the streets, Cardi B, and the queen of rap, Nicki Minaj. But most think in the moment the two should be standing tall together, they're tearing each other down. Let's have a listen and see what you think. Now, I know what you're thinking, as Cardi clearly said she doesn't have time for beef in that little snippet. But if you take a look closer, she also stated, you don't want problems with her. You don't. I know I don't. And many shots were thrown, but those could be easily directed at former rap nemesis Remy Ma. Let's go ahead and wrap this segment up with a quick congratulations to Offset and Cardi B in their engagement. All right, and that's all from Excuse Me. Remember, if it's not our business, soon it will be. And if it's not about me, we sip tea.